first time I trained Jiu Jitsu, I felt like crap. You know, because I went to the gym, to the school, and I think that was like a badass Muay Thai guy fighter, could like punch, kick, whatever, did boxing, English box too. And then I got my ass whooped pretty bad. If you see somebody from Jiu Jitsu that say, I know everything, it's full of shit. My name is Fabio Novaes. Nowadays, I'm a Jiu Jitsu instructor. I'm also an architect from Brazil. I got introduced to Jiu Jitsu by my cousin. He was a blue belt in Jiu Jitsu, so I was like a Muay Thai fighter from my family, né? The one that fights all the time, had trophies and all that. My cousin's only a blue belt in Jiu Jitsu, so he used to beat me up really bad. I was 18, turned 19 in college. I had a 50-year-old kid tie me out 5 times, play with me like I was nothing. Pop my arm, choked me out a couple of times, and then that's how I kind of felt like useless. You know, like I had a 50-year-old kid, somebody that normally take for granted, play with me like didn't even break a sweat. My transition to come to the West was pretty easy. But then when I came over here, started living over here, ended up staying, started teaching Jiu-Jitsu to like keep my Jiu-Jitsu. And I was working as an architect in the office. Then years went by, the Jiu-Jitsu started growing. I ended up having to work part-time in the architectural office. Until I did resign because the schools ended up growing, I could not like it. I started my own gym because like I overgrew a place. And I even heard people saying like, if that guy was good, he's having one place. Why my own place? Why am I gonna have over there? Yeah. But my goal is to grow and maybe open a place.
My name is Roberta Capelluto. I'm Fabio's wife. I manage both schools that we have. We have a school in Brandon and a school in Lakeland. And Fabio only teaches. Everything else is up to me. I cannot complain about my job at all. We have it was very hard in the beginning, you know. We used to work way more, but nowadays I cannot complain. It's very easygoing, you know. I love what I do. I know he loves what he does. So it's awesome. We really love it, and it's not hard. And it's been, I would say, 18 years that he's been teaching. So it's been a long time that we've been dealing with that and just growing, thanks God. 20 years later, the rest is history.
The Jiu-Jitsu, when I teach Jiu-Jitsu, I try to change people's lifestyles. Everybody that comes over here, you get what you call the welcome. Where's the welcome? People only go to tap you out without leaving a bruise. Why? I don't hurt you here, I don't hurt you here. That's how I felt. When I left the place, I felt somebody squish my heart like that. I felt somebody went, kalima, and pull my heart out, you know? And tap on, pum, here. Over here, the white belt and the black belt, all the same. You're the same. The only difference is one guy has more experience than another. Same. I'm over here, so I tell everybody. You're in the mountain. Everybody's there. If somebody brings the head off here, I chop off right away. Because you're all the same. Nobody needs to go here. You know, if you're all the same, you help each other. The only difference about the belts is more experience. Other than that, you all need each other. It has no shadow of jiu-jitsu. If I see you grapple somebody and you feel really good, I'm going to put you to grapple somebody if you feel really bad. And then it goes like that here. I want you leave over here in a straight line. Not too happy, not too sad, you know? Maybe sometimes if you're too happy, I need to make you a little sad, you know? Because like reality is like that. Life beats it up, it's up, you know? But like, I want people to feel that like you have something to learn, you know what I mean? Same, I'm still learning, you know? Like how many new positions you all the time? People working like you. One of the reasons I even worked as a referee before for Jiu-Jitsu is because I could see the new Jiu-Jitsu going on and I could practice it, you know? You know, I'm still learning and I'll be learning forever. Like the game in Jiu-Jitsu is like a chess game. You move your pawn, I move my pawn, that's how it goes, no? You know, I need that. I think that's how it's supposed to, you know? Like, same, fear. You need to fear everything, too. When you fear something, kind of respect you, you know what I mean? Not fear in the way that you kind of, no. You respect, you know? Like, you expect anything that can happen. You know, that you're always ready for, like, whatever, you know?
I absolutely love working with Jiu-Jitsu because first of all, I am completely in love with this sport. The martial art that teaches you that you don't have to rely on strength or size, but leverage and technique. I do understand that Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is not for everybody. It can be very overwhelming, you know, when you step on the mat and you see those guys and those girls like this, sweating on top of each other. I do understand that is not for everybody. But if you're willing to give it a try, just as a hobby, to lose some weight, to build some self-confidence, it is so worth it. I know for a fact a lot of students had their lives changed because they found the school, because they found Fabio. They either told us, they wrote him letters, you know, thanking him. We had wives coming and talking to us and thanking us. My husband has changed. We have another life today. He's such a happy person. So I know for a fact that he had a lot of impact in a lot of people's lives. It all started after they opened the door for the school and tried jiu-jitsu and became friends and became students.
When you come over here to train, you're looking for different ways. You know, also confidence. You know how many people come over here with zero confidence? You know, like kind of shy or even like afraid of everything, you know? When you're not afraid of like getting beat up, better saying, you kind of walk on the street like you feel a little more safe. Going to the kids, you see the kids come over here, the parents, kids that get beat up in school, that get bullied in school. First thing you see, they come behind their parents, hide their face, you know? They are like, hey, how are you? And see the kid kind of like shake your hand, always kind of like, how can I say, he's not trusting anything, you know? He's always, and then you see, start training, month go by, 2 months go by, then you see the kids are like, the chest kind of go up a little bit, yeah? They start walking from the parents, and then, one day, the parents get called to school because the kid didn't beat up the bully. That's what like, I like the most, you know, like when the kids feel confident enough to fight back.
It's amazing to watch kids, adults that come over here looking for help, either because of bullying or depression or a possible divorce, and they find in jiu-jitsu something to look for. They build their confidence, they change their lives. So that is an amazing part of what we do. Months later, you can see, let's say, a 15-year-old girl going against a 17-year-old boy and making him tap, and that feeling that she gets home, that she can defend herself. You know, she believes in herself.
My name is Franklin Green, and I've been doing this since I was 50, and I'm now 59. I'll be 60 this year, and I'm a blue belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I've been with Fabio 10 years now, and I'm gonna tell you something. There's no one with a more generous heart. There's a young lady, and her confidence was zero when she started, zero. And she kept saying, no, I'm not good at this. No, I can't do this. And she has grown into a very, very skilled practitioner. And she's awesome. She's awesome. But more importantly, her confidence level is through the roof. She's just one of many that I've seen grow like that. This is not just for your skill level, the physical part of it. It's also the mental part of it. And watching someone grow from a white belt to a brown belt is amazing. Their confidence level. Yeah, it's incredible.
My name is Jonathan Ocasio. I've been doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for about 6 years now. I'm a purple belt under Fabio Novaes Jiu Jitsu. The impact that Fabio had in my life and others that I've seen is tremendous. And he was telling me one story. He said, John, you're going to know, because remember, you're getting better. Everybody else is getting better as well. But when somebody else new comes in, you'll know how good you are. But remember this from right now. You're telling me you're not getting better, and I know you're getting better. Keep humble, stay humble, be humble. If not, we're all in a huddle. We're in a team, even me. And I run the show. My name is in the front door. We're all huddling up in a huddle. And if you pick up your head, the first person that's going to chop off your head is going to be me. That's helped me, like I said, in my personal life, being a better father, being a better husband, being a better a friend.
No, over here, what I try over the gym is have like a family environment. We all human beings. We all need to help each other. We all need each other. That's why I like this over here. It's my little mafia.
We have a great family in jiu-jitsu, a great, amazing family in jiu-jitsu. So it's very good to work on a daily basis with people that you love.
I'm still here because there is a very good and strong family atmosphere. It has been from the start. Fabio is a very important and integral part of this family.
In the gym and as a person, we respect each other, and that's because of Fabio, 100%. I can say whatever to my brother, but you can't say anything to my brother if you're not in this group. Fabio says, I don't want you to go talk and take pictures with the guy that won gold. I want you to talk to the person that lost and tell them, we're going to work on this that you lost. I'm good at this position that you lost in, and we're going to help you get better until you can win next time. Once you're under his wing, you're his guy, good or bad, you know?
If Fabio were not here it wouldn't be the same.
Sometimes you gotta close the door to open a window.
Spectrum.